discuss the mechanics of JUnit testing and warn you of fatal mistakes you might make. We do this without really testing anything, allowing us to concentrate on the mechanics of testing. Here is the initial JUnit testing class, See Tester 1. It has one procedure, which is preceded by the annotation at test. Procedure test contains a call on procedure fail, which always fails. With class CTest1 selected in the Package Explorer pane, use menu item run. This causes method test to be called, and the results are displayed in a new JUnit testing pane where the Package Explorer pane was. A thick bar appears, indicating that an error occurred. Calling procedure test caused an error because procedure fail always causes an error. Let's remove the call on procedure fail in method test and use menu item run again. Now, execution of a call on procedure test did not produce an error, so the JUnit pane has a green arrow. We now have two testing procedures in class CTest1, named Test1 and Test2. Procedure Test1 has an empty procedure body. Test2 has the call on procedure fail. Again, with JUnit testing class CTester1 selected in the Package Explorer pane, use menu item run. Hey, the JUnit testing pane indicates that there were no errors, in spite of the fact that procedure test 2 calls procedure fail. What happened? Procedure test 1 was called because it was preceded by the annotation at test. But procedure test 2 was not called because it was not preceded by annotation at test. Only procedures that are preceded by that annotation will be called. We can see that procedure test 2 is not called in another way. Click the horizontal arrow that precedes CTester 1 in the JUnit testing pane. The contents of that folder are revealed. Only test 1 and not test 2 was called. The green check just before test 1 indicates that it ran without error. Always check in this manner that all the procedures were executed. Click the horizontal arrow to reveal the contents of the folder and make sure that all expected procedures are listed and all have green check marks next to them. We do one more thing. We put the at test annotation before procedure test 2, but change its body to have an infinite while loop. Again, we run the program using run. Hey, there's the green bar, but it is only half as long as it should be. Secondly, while the contents of CTester1 indicates that procedure test 1 completed, procedure test 2 didn't. It has a blue arrow instead of a check mark, which means that the procedure is in an infinite loop. In summary, always check that all procedures were called and that their calls completed.